So in this section we will see the types of relationship, multiple regression and all. So before proceeding we must clarify what types of relationships are necessary, which are mainly known as deterministic relationship or the functional relationship. So function is a deterministic relationship between input and output values. So what is function? Function is a deterministic relationship. And how the relationship is there? It is in between input and output values. So for each deterministic relationship, the equation exactly describes the relationship between two variables. So whenever we are talking about the deterministic relationship, the equation describes the relationship between what? It describes the relationship between two variables. So in statistical relationship, the relationship between two variables is not perfect. So that is the thing. Basically what we are doing, we are studying the deterministic relationship and the functional relationship. So in deterministic relationship, it describes the relationship between two variables. And in statistical relationship, the relationship is between the variables is not the perfect one. So these are the basic two types of relationship. That is the deterministic relationship, which is also called as the functional relationship or statistical relationship. So the next part is the multiple regression. We have seen regression, then we have seen linear regression. Now we will see the multiple regression. So what is multiple regression? So it is extension of linear regression. We have seen linear regression already. So it is the extension of linear regression. In linear regression, value of one unknown variable is predicted with one known variable. So what is done? The linear regression's capability is extended. If the value of unknown variable, if predicted using values of two or more unknown variable, then it is called as the multiple regression analysis. What we are doing? We are trying to predict the value of unknown variable, and when that is predicted using the values of two or more unknown variables, then it is called as the multiple regression analysis, which is the extension of linear regression. So now we will see what are the uses or why the linear regression is so important. So the major uses of linear regressions we are going to see. The major uses of linear regression are determining the strength of predictors, forecasting an effect, and the trained forecasting. So the regression might be used to identify the strength of the effect that the independent variable have on dependent variable. Why regression is used? Because we are trying to find out the independent variable, which is basically based on the dependent variable. So what is the strength of the relationship between them? So that is all the things are used in sales, marketing, age, income, everything. Then it can be used to forecast effects or impact of changes. That is the second one. So regression analysis helps us to understand how much the dependent variable changes with a change in one or more independent variables. Means suppose we are talking about sales. Then how much additional sales income do I get for each additional 1000 rupees if I spent on the marketing? So that's why it is forecasting an effect. Means if we are doing some changes, then what will be the outcome of that? That is forecasting an effect. The third one is the trend forecasting. The regression analysis predicts trends and future values. Means the regression analysis is used to get some point estimates, that is what will be the price of gold after 6 months and all. So that is nothing but trend forecasting. So these are the major uses of linear regression, that is determining the strength of predictors, which is applicable in the marketing, share marketing. Forecasting an effect means suppose whenever we are talking about any particular income or additional sales, then what will be the outcome? And the next one is trend forecasting, means after 6 months, what will be the trend? What will be the cost? That is nothing but trend forecasting. So this is all about the multiple regression, which is the extension of linear regression and uses of linear regression. In our next section, we will continue with the logistic regression. Thank you.